Astronomy fans are getting ready for a really cool event this weekend.
A solar eclipse will be visible in parts of the United States, and Northern California is in a pretty good spot to see it. We go now to meteorologist Heather Waldman joining us live at Sacramento State with what we can expect and how we'll be able to see it, or if we'll be able to see it. Heather?
Yeah, and you may have heard this eclipse referred to as a ring of fire eclipse. That's kind of a little clue as to what this phenomenon could look like at its peak. And yeah, we will be in a good position to see it here in Northern California. So earlier today, I met up with the director of the Sac State Planetarium. We talked about the science, we talked about what we could see, and more importantly, how to see it safely.
It is this very special combination of something bizarre that we're not used to and something scientific.
On Saturday morning, the Earth, Moon, and Sun will align in an annular solar eclipse, a celestial event that you can only see if you're in the right place at the right time.
We tend to get one maybe like every other year, somewhere on the globe. But to have one happen where you actually are is much more rare.
And this time around, Sacramento will experience almost the full effect of the moon passing in front of the sun. Dr. Kyle Waters brought us into the planetarium at Sac State to show us what it'll look like.
Everything is going to start. The show is going to start a little after 8 a.m., right around 8:05 a.m. The moon is going to kind of slowly increase its coverage from 8:05 to 9:20, and then it'll slowly decrease from 9:20 to about 10:45. Here in Sacramento, it'll be about 85% of the sun will be covered by the moon. This is a good partial eclipse.
To see peak coverage for Saturday's eclipse, you'd have to head north. But unlike with a total solar eclipse, no one will experience that totality effect that some saw in 2017.
The difference maker is where the moon is.
For this weekend's annular solar eclipse, the moon is a bit farther from Earth, making it look like it's blocking less of the sun's disk. But Waters says that even with 85% coverage expected Saturday, you need to protect your eyes before you look up.
So you do need a pair of eclipse glasses, not sunglasses. Sunglasses are not good enough. You need a proper pair of eclipse glasses.
And here is what those eclipse glasses look like. If they look familiar, well, maybe you've got a pair left over from 2017. If you do still have those, they'll work just fine. If you need a new pair, well, Sac State's going to be handing out 500 pairs for free on Saturday morning. The astronomy department is hosting a watch party for the eclipse right here at the planetarium. It starts at 8 a.m. It goes until 11 a.m. They'll have lots of family-friendly activities. The event is free. The parking is also free. So again, good spot to come out and watch, learn about what you're seeing as well, and of course, learn how to do it safely. All of that, of course, depending on the weather. So we're hoping for a nice break in the clouds when the eclipse peaks at 9:20 on Saturday morning. Live at the Sac State Planetarium, I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman. Back to you.
That's awesome. Free, free, and free.
Mm-hmm.
Can't
love
beat it. And you're going to learn something.